Actually, the one now mode looks like this, where you will have Netscaler will have only one interface. Your NSIP can be in any VLAN, any interface. That's different. We are talking about only the data traffic. So you will have one interface, and you know you will have one VLAN where VIP and SNIP will be there. So this is one arm mode. If you talk about two arm mode, you will have VIP in one interface and subnet IP in different interface. Meaning to say, the traffic will go from one interface and go back from other interface to the backend servers. You know, so we will see this also. So, and the third case is, let's say we have multiple arms, like this is DMZ, this is development, this is production. So let's say, you know, if you have a VIP is this and backend servers are this, the traffic will flow from VIP to the backend servers like this. So this is a typical multi-arm mode. So finally, we will configure like this. The same IPs I will configure in the Netscaler. Please remember this, you know, routing table and these IPs now. Go to system, network and interfaces. As you can see here, system network interfaces. Then you can see I have 0/1. Generally 0/1 is your management interface where you will connect the Netscaler IP, NSIP, right? Now 1.1/1 is on the right hand side. If you want to know more details about this, please refer to the hardware configuration video, which I left the link in the description below. 1/1, you know, in my case, what I will do now, first, I will start with one arm mode, two arm mode and multi arm mode. So what we will do, first we'll do only one arm mode with only one interface, right? 1/1. Then two arm mode with two interfaces, the multi arm mode with three interfaces. So I'll use all the interfaces in the last. See, one arm mode, two arm mode, multi arm mode is nothing. It's very easy. If you want to know the details about all these one arm, two arm, multi arm mode, I had created a separate video. It's purely theory and it's very in-depth. It will explain you even the basics of switching and routing also. Please refer to that. The link is in the description below. First, when we need to configure the one arm mode, you know, like we have discussed, what we have to do, we need to add the subnet IPs, because you know, VIPs are something which we'll configure later when we are configuring services, but subnet IP is something very important. So click on system network IPs and click on add. You need to give the IP address. So in my case, it is 192.168.10.11 is my subnet IP. The mask is 255.255.255.0. It is the type is subnet IP. Select the subnet IP as type. Come down, no need to do anything here. Just say create, you know. So what I'm trying to do now, I am not only adding one subnet IP, this subnet IP is for my DMZ. I have another subnet IP for my development and production. I will add them also. So as we can see here, I have added three subnet IPs. One 192.168.10.11. This is for my DMZ. Another one for my development. This one 10.10 is for my production. Means it's for different zones, you know. So typically in your environment, most of the customers, you will have either one arm mode or two arm mode. One arm mode means you will have only one subnet IP. Two arm mode means you will have two subnet IPs like this, you know. Now let's go to the network and VLANs. Click on add and create the VLAN. Let's say my DMZ VLAN is 10 and what I am alias name, I will put DMZ interface binding. I will use 1/1. As we know, 0/1 is only for management. Now we can see something called tagged here. What is tagged? If your switch port where you connected this 1/1 interface on the switch on the other end, if it is a trunk port, the network team will generally allow the VLAN ID 10 on their trunk. Then you need to select the tagged here because your VLAN is your port is on a trunk port. But in my case, it is access port, so I am not tagging here. Okay, if it is trunk, you need to tag. Then click on IP bindings. When you click on IP bindings, you can see all the subnet IPs here. So in my case, I have 192.168.10.11 is my subnet IP, right, for DMZ. I'll select this and I'll come down and I'll say create. So the moment I say that, you can see here the interface has come from here to here. Now it is one arm mode. All you need to check is only routing. The physical appliance will never be shipped with the default route, which is 0000. So you need to add the default route always it's recommended to add the default route to the DMZ interface. Or let's say if you have one arm mode, you have one interface, right? Your subnet IP is 192.168.10.11, and for that subnet the gateway is 10.1. you need to put the default route gateway as 10.1. so I'll click on add and I will add the network. What I'm doing, I'm creating the default route, right? Network is 0000, netmask is 0000, and gateway is 192.168.10.1, which is my one arm mode subnet IP gateway. That's it. Click on create. Once you click on create, the default route is created, which is C, distance is 1 and a static. So let's say, what is default route? If none of the routes which you created are not there, by default, you know, the default route will be selected and all the traffic will be sent to this gateway. That is the meaning of default route. Now with this, actually your one arm mode is done, means you implemented one arm mode. You know, you have one interface and you tagged the IP, subnet IP, to that interface and you created default route. Now let's say you want to go to two arm mode, where you have, you know, where, you know, you want to send the traffic to the backend servers from a different subnet IP, you know, then what you will do, it's very simple. Go to the VLANs. It is two arm mode now. If you are, what I am creating, let's say my development VLAN ID is 110. This is say dev VLAN, right? 1/2 is for development. I am not tagging because mine is access port. If it is trunk, please tag it. Click on binding and you need to select the subnet IP of dev. See, for me subnet IP is 172.16.10.11, right? Select it and click create. That's it. Now once you created this, you need to go to the routing and you need to create a static route. Now what you need to do, the static route is very simple. My development super subnet is 172.16. So I'll allow anything in that VLAN, 255.255, means I mean to say anything in this, my gateway is this, means the subnet IP of the development VLAN, you know, will be used. This is the meaning of it. And say create. So now this static route is created, right? So with this, your two arm mode is done. With this, the two arm mode is done. Let's say this production is not at there, you know. So what we created the DMZ, we created internal. So even though you have VIPs, you don't have VIPs, you need to create the subnet IP because it's a two arm mode, right? Let's say your virtual IP is this and backend servers are these, you know. What happens then in two arm mode, your traffic will come to the virtual IP like this and it will be sent to the Netscaler using the SNIP. Because how the SNIP will know? Because you created a default route for this subnet 172.16.0.0, right? So who is in that subnet? This SNIP. And which interface? You already created a VLAN and you tagged it, right? So that's how Netscaler will know, and it will be sent to the gateway which you created in the default, in the static route, right? Then the traffic will be sent back. Whatever traffic coming from the backend servers will be sent to the Netscaler. Now if the Netscaler don't know the some other traffic, right, it will be by default sent to the DMZ interface because that is a default route. So two arm mode is very simple. This is two arm mode configuration. Now let's move to multi arm mode. System network VLAN, create another VLAN. Let's say my production VLAN 210 and name I had given. Just scroll down. I am selecting the interface third one because first two we already use, right? I am not tagging because mine is access port. Go to the IP binding again, scroll down and select the 10.10.10.11. This is a subnet IP for production, right? Click on create. So now what happens? Another interface is gone. So every interface has its own VLAN. So meaning to say, what we are trying to tell is here that we created a VLAN and with that VLAN, we are binding the interface to the subnet IP. Same, this is for DMZ, this is for development, this is for production. This is how Netscaler will know. And the final thing we need to do, just to create one route. That's it. Go to the routes and my production, let's say supernet is 10.0.0.0 and mask is this, means anything after 10, right? Because I'm mask, I put only 255, anything after 10, you know, I am sending the back traffic back to 10.10.10.1, meaning to say this is the gateway and the subnet IP which is in this VLAN will be used. Click on create. Now that's it. With this, you know what you have done? You have done the multi-arm mode implementation. It's very simple. So how the traffic flows, let's see again. So how the traffic flows for multi-arm mode, just when a user traffic is coming to the VIP, let's say for this VIP, these are your backend servers, the traffic will flow from here, it will go back. And let's say you have another VIP called 192.168.10.15, and these are your backend servers. The traffic will go back using this SNIP. All it is happening because of the static routes you have created. I have shown you how to create, right? The default route to always the DMZ interface. And if you have 2-ARM mode, the whatever is your backend servers, all the servers, that's you can create individual subnets, static route, or maybe the preferred is a super subnet, and create that to the gateway of your internal SNIP. If you have multi-ARM mode, as I had shown you, each zone static route to that. We have implemented the multi-ARM mode design. Include one, first we have seen 1-ARM mode, then 2-ARM mode, then multi-ARM mode. If you want to know the theory of it, because I showed you the practical, just have a look at the video in the description below. Then if you see this video, it will make a lot of sense for you. Thanks for watching the video. Please like and subscribe to the channel, like the video and share with your friends and colleagues. And most importantly, please complete all the videos in this series, because it is very helpful and you'll gain a lot of knowledge. If you have any comments, please feel free to leave your comments down. You might be interested in my blog, shivashankar.org. It has all the detailed installation and configuration details of most of the products. Thank you.